Let's go.
Right now, we're going to open things up with an exclusive video from the VP of Operations.
Well, well, well. Everybody, welcome back to the OEW, or should I say, welcome back to me. That sounds even better. Welcome back to me. But, you know, I won't divulge on me being back, so I'm just going to get right into it today for all of you here. Been a little busy in my office, so I haven't been able to make it down to the ring yet, but I do have an announcement to make. So, I'm going to get right into that so I can finish doing what I need to do. So, I just want to let you guys know that I am officially reinstating the Winter Invitational, but there's going to be a slight hiccup. It's going to be rebranded as the OEW Invitational. That's right. There's going to be 8 men who will set foot in the ring, with the winner winning the OEW medallion for a chance to win the OEW title at any time. So, with that in hand, we're going to get started for that. So, everybody enjoy the show.
Well, well, well. Welcome back, Chiesa. Guess who's back? Me too.
Oh, wait a minute.
See?
I know that voice.
Yeah. They looked into me being fired by you before and found it ungrounded. And they saw fit to have me come back. So, I'm back. And, you know, I'm not going to tolerate any more of the crap, because you can't get away with everything. As you can see, I'm back, even though I'm pretty sure you don't want me back.
Oh, honey, you seem to think that I can't do what I want to do. Well, sweetheart, I have a little bit of word for you there. I run this place, and the only reason you're back is because it was allowed. But it's okay, honey. I don't have time for all of this bullshit right here with you. So, why don't
you? Yeah, the only reason you don't have a say is because, yeah, if you did, it'd be illegal, and you'd have to fork out a hell of a lot of cash, and I'm pretty sure they don't want to do that. And all I ever wanted to do was wrestle in the first place. So, yeah, whether you liked it or not, you don't have a choice. It went over your pay grade. Good.
How about you take your little ass back to BCW where you can continue on jobbing yourself out and get out my office?
You think I'm jobbing? Oh, wow. Really? Is that why I'm still guaranteed a title shot over there? If I'm jobbing, then why do I have a title shot coming? Yeah. Really? Do you honestly think that I can't get anything? I was the champion here twice. It's like, and you need me here, whether you think you do or not. Oh, I'll be back. And I'll be back with a vengeance. Don't you worry.
Wow. Honey Pots is making her way back to the OEW. You know, Danza, wasn't that long ago, less than a year ago, where Tiesa fired Honey Pots. She actually fired her for the promotion. And Honey Pots hasn't been seen since. But wow, with this new BCW, OEW thing, working together thing, I mean, the door's open now, I guess.
So, Connor, as you all recall, LBA was trying to entice her back to OEW. Looks like he succeeded, and it's good to see Honey Pots back. Can't wait to see her in an OEW ring. But, of course, what about that? An epic announcement from the VP, Tiesa Piers, that we will have the return of the Winter Invitational Tournament, now called the OEW Tournament, and it's going to be for the medallion. The winner of the medallion will get a title shot any place, anywhere, anytime.
Last year, I was lucky enough to be on commentary during the OEW Winter Invitational, which was done before Christmas, and I witnessed Tank Ventura win that medallion last year. We know what happened with that medallion. He cashed that in, and he won the world title. So whoever the participants are going to be in this tournament, maybe one of them will be lucky enough to have the same success that Tank Ventura had.
That's right, Paul, and I guess it would be fair to say that the winner will get money in the bank if you smell what I'm cooking. And, of course, one epic main event it was in last year's tournament. It was the Maui Maho Koa going against Tank, and we all know how that story was told. We live today in the era of Tank Ventura.
Yeah, we are definitely in the era of Tank. But I tell you what, Tank has his hands full right now with Skillix, so we got to see how that plays out, Danza.
Yes, he does. Speaking of Skillix, he'll be in our main event tonight, of course, against the former Hardcore Champion, Alex Camino. They go 1-1 tonight on Ascension.
Should be interesting, but let's not forget, also who's going to be in action tonight, I am issuing an open challenge to any woman who has the man nuts to come into the ring and face my girl Bree tonight.
Well, we, of course, have a plethora of great female superstars here in OEW. That should be a very, very interesting encounter, whoever accepts that open challenge. Okay, I think we're almost ready for our first match of the evening. And guess what? It will be part of the OEW Invitational Tournament. Here we go.
Well, Tiesa comes back, and I mean, she starts off with a bang, reissuing this tournament. Here we go.
That's right, Paul. I'm about to introduce the contenders in the first quarterfinal of the OEW Invitational Tournament. The winner will receive the OEW Medallion. Making his way to the ring at 6'4", at 270 pounds. From Hannah Maui, here is the Maui Marvel Koa.
I think this ritual tournament, I mean, he didn't fare too well. Lost in the finals to Tank Ventura, but he's back to get some, try to retry it, I guess, with Danza trying to, maybe this luck will change this one, because since Tank's not in the tournament.
As you can see, Paul, Koa doing the, I believe it's the Haka. Is it the Haka ritual dance? Ritualistic dance?
I don't know what that dance is. It looks ridiculous, though.
I think that's what Alexi Maga called it last week. And yes, he's looking to work his way back to the final. Can he do it again? Can he repeat the magic, but this time win the medallion? Is luck on his side this year, Paul?
I don't know. I mean, we'll have to see, Danza.
And introducing his opponent. He's about to make his way down the aisle, standing at 6'1", at 235 pounds, from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Here is Retro Parker, the one. Yes, and the Retro One in the ring, ready to square off in this first opening match of the OEW Invitational Tournament. This is going to be very exciting between these two, Paul.
Well, Parker the One, I mean, Parker's pretty good. And guess what about Parker? The shirt he's wearing right now, Danzy, you can pick it up in our merch store directly across the street from our arena. Parker's shirt on sale right now.
Absolutely, yes. And all your great favorite wrestling superstars, we've got merchandise, t-shirts, we've got the tanks, we've got everything. We've got things for the men and the women. Be sure to check that out after Ascension, opposite the arena. Oh, this is a great looking Scumbag Superstars t-shirt over there too. Now Bill Warren's checking down on Parker the One. And we're about to get underway in our first encounter on Ascension. Yeah, this is going to be a very interesting match. These two, highly competitively spirited. Who is on the precipice of destiny? We will find out. And these two going eye to eye. Feeling the intensity of these two, Paul.
I mean, Oh, Parker has the speed over Koa, but Koa definitely has the strength over Parker, so...
Parker leaping at Koa with a fist. Oh, what an impact. Yes, he does. He meets that big boot, Paul. And Parker is down on the square circle. A wrist lock now by Parker. And these two are fairly evenly matched. Not too much difference in height and weight, but Koa seems to have a slight advantage.
Definitely a slight advantage, and like I said, Parker the One is little faster than Koa. Koa definitely has a strength advantage, but you know how these things go, Danza. Any That's given right. Sunday, they say, for football, that could go as well as any given Sunday here at OEW.
That's right, Paul. An arm drag takedown by Parker. Taking early control of this match with Koa. Koa sending Parker into the ropes. And another big boot.
Big boot.
Second vicious big boot there, Paul. Back to his feet very quickly. Going to nip up. Koa turning things around early now. You can tell. Oh, what a DDT. Sending Parker face first into the ring. And back to his feet immediately. A stomp. Stomp on the ribs of Parker. That's going to hurt with his bare feet.
Parker the advantage right now. There's an Irish whip into the ropes.
Indeed he does, Paul. Oh, he comes back with a clothesline. What a rebound.
Did you pick up your Parker to One shirt today, Dancer?
I sure did. Building quite the collection there, Paul. That's quite a good choice we have in our merchandise store as we broadcast on YouTube. Be sure to like us. And we're also on Twitter, aka X. Our handle is WrestlingOEW. Now Parker. Oh, Parker giving a DDT.
Speaking of X, you know, I had to block that idiot Casey King this week because he chimes in all my tweets like he's going to try to send me a message. See, he's blocked.
Casey King, our head of production on the videography and the camera work, he does a great job each and every week here on Ascension.
Whoa. Great's pushing it. He does an adequate job.
I don't know about that, but as Koa is sent into the ropes, he spears and takes down Parker, coming back right into this match. Oh, he can smell that medallion, Paul. Remember that medallion. Good. Yes, Paul, remember that medallion gives you a title shot at the World Men's Heavyweight title. Any given time, you could do it after a main event when the new champion or the existing champion is exhausted. You can take advantage whenever it suits you. A kick to midsection by Koa, sending another DDT. Third DDT in this match, Paul.
Yes, a lot of DDTs in this match. There's a pin.
One, two, and a kick out. Close, but no cigar. Parker's not going to give up that easily early in this match. And Koa jumping back to his feet rapidly. Locking up. Who has the greatest strength? And Koa sending Parker into the ropes yet again. Oh!
Ooh.
Hurricanrana by Parker. What a superb maneuver. That was very well done. Nicely. Yes, it was.
And that's the one thing Parker's good at. Parker's very, very good at that.
Absolutely, Paul. Speed and agility coming to his assistance and sending Gore into the ropes. Now Gore.
I had a conversation with Koa earlier today. I said, Koa, how do you feel about being in the... Oh, there's a pin.
Super kick and a pin. One, two, and a kick out. Sorry, what were you saying, Paul?
I said to Koa, I said, hey, Koa, I see you're in the match. You're in the... You're going to get another shot at the medallion since you lost last year because you're a loser. I mean, how do you feel about going in? You know what he said to me? You know what he said, Danza? He's like,
tell me.
Hoo-ah, 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 hoo-ah. I don't even know what that means. I don't even know what that means. So I just walked away from it.
I guess it would be fair to say you were lost in translation as Parker applies the figure four leg lock to Koa right in the center of the ring. Painful maneuver. And now you can tell Koa needs to reach to those ropes, but he's too far away right now, writhing in pain, Paul.
And Bill Lawrence
checking to... Yes, but... Oh! And a release. Oh, Koa manages to break the maneuver. Luckily for him, not easy to do. But he was in dangerous territory right there. We're going to come close to a submission. This match can be, of course, decided by pinfall submission. And you can advance to the semi-finals of the tournament.
Working on the leg. That tournament final, Danza, I don't know if you mentioned it. That tournament final will be at Immortality.
Yes, that's absolutely right. Immortality, 4 weeks away today. The granddaddy of them all, our Super Bowl, our WrestleMania. Yes, Immortality, 4 weeks away. It's going to be absolutely off the page. And, of course, we will have our title tournament final, as you rightly said, Paul. That is going to be
let's just speak hypothetically here, Danza. Let's just speak hypothetically. Let's just say Koa wins. Let's just say Koa advances to the final, okay? And he wins. He could actually cash in that night of the final if he wanted to.
Yes, he could. Or he could sit in it. He could wait a week, a month, 2 months. Oh, elbow from the top rope. What incredible balance. Reminiscent of Mark Calloway, The Undertaker, who used to walk those ropes. And Parker did it.
Yeah, Parker's very good. And one of the most underrated wrestlers, in my opinion, in the OEW is Parker the One.
Absolutely, an excellent equilibrium by Parker using that rope as an advantage. And what a flying elbow. Never seen a flying elbow from the top rope before.
Oh, Parker, don't do that. This is Parker's main problem. Is he likes to show these fans his appreciation, and he waves to them and shows all his crap. This is what causes the matches a lot.
So, and you've got to be careful it doesn't gravitate into... losing your attention and allowing your opponent to take advantage, which is what's happening right now with Koa.
Koa definitely taking advantage of it.
Series of kicks by Koa. The distraction proving to be the weakness of Parker, as you rightly said, Paul. Oh, the spine buster taking Parker right into the mat. What velocity and intensity that spine buster was, Paul. Koa now firmly in charge. And Parker paying the price for posing to the fans. You got to keep your attention on your opponent at all times, especially in an invitational tournament like this one.
I mean, this is the invitation that puts you right into the main event. You're the number one contender, technically, for the world OEW World Heavyweight Championship.
Yes, it is a chance, an opportunity to be the best in our industry, to be at the top of the mountain. And this is what these eight contenders will be trying to do over the next ensuing weeks, which will result at Immortality. What a super kick. Oh, Parker running into the corner, meeting the super kick of Koa.
And Parker needs...
Parker back to his feet. Looking quite exhausted. I think that spine buster winded him earlier in this match, Paul. And now, on, sending the knee into the midsection of Koa in the corner, and now Koa is in trouble. Oh, punching his gut. Oh, taking lots of punishment in the corner. Cole needs to get out of there. And the referee should be applying the count to get them out of there. Oh, and a choke. He's choking the life out of Cole. But Warren's not happy about what he's seeing. Demanding a retreat. Well, I don't think Parker is in a very giving mood tonight. He knows all is at stake. And keeping Cole into the corner. Oh, smashing his head into the turnbuckle face first. Oh, that's going to hurt.
Wow.
I think Cole right now is seeing stars, Paul.
He definitely is seeing stars right now, it looks like.
Now taking Cole into the front face lock, dragging him to the very center of the ring. And Cole into the ropes.
Oh!
Oh, the leg lariat by Parker! Oh, he took Cole down right there. What a vicious leg lariat, Paul. And the cover.
There's a pin.
One, two, three. It's over. Here is your winner by pinfall. Parker. The one. Retro Parker.
Wow, this has to be a big upset. Really, not really an upset, but wow. Cole had to be coming in here. One of the odds-on favorites to win this tournament. For him to lose.
Yes, it was.
Lose in the first round is almost shocking, Danza.
A stunning upset. Last year's finalist out in the quarterfinals of the tournament. And Parker advances. He goes to the semifinals, Paul. One step closer. That unbelievable prize of the OEW medallion. That world title shot.
Wow.
Congratulations to Parker. Very stunning victory as he advances in the Invitational Tournament.
Wow, unbelievable. Parker to one advancing, one step closer of winning that medallion. Wow,
yes,
this is going to be some tournament, Dennis. This is going to be some tournament, I'll tell you that.
Yes, we do have another quarterfinal that will take place tonight here on Ascension.
She may need another lesson learned.
Yeah, let's not be encouraging any further brawls. I think last week in the cesspool, that brawl was quite enough. Okay. It's now time for our next match. Making her way to the ring. Standing at 5'8" and 138 pounds. From Kyoto, Japan. Here is the Shinobi Mizu Sayuri. Of course, we last saw Mizu defeat Abigail at Mind Games. She's on quite the roll, and I think she'll be looking...
Absolutely, I was just going to say that. You put the words right out of my mouth. As Mizu is kind of on a roll since her debut. Her re-debut, I should say, back into the OEW. She took down Lawson, and she's been on a roll since. But she's got her hands full today with Casey King's best friend, Emma Gray.
Oh, yes. Speaking of a roll, here's another one who's been on a roll. Her opponent is about to make her way to the ring at 5'3" and 125 pounds from Belfast, Ireland. Here is Emma Gray! Yes, of course, Emma Gray too also has been on quite the rampage also. Last week she defeated Daisy Sue, your favourite wrestler there, Paul.
Yeah, I've been paying attention to what Volcano and Emma Gray have been doing.
Yeah, so let's go in the feud between Emma Gray and Volcano.
It's Belfast Moving Island, Danza. Get it right.
Well, it depends which side of the island that you were talking about, because some people have a different interpretation of it. Let's not go there, Paul. It's a long story, a long troubled story of history there. Of course, this match is going to be very exciting because both these superstars are both on a rampage and both looking to secure a victory to advance their career, because I think both of these two great wrestlers, these two great superstars are viable contenders for a women's championship match. What do you say, Paul?
Well, we'll see. Emma Gray's another one who tries to tweet at me, who tries to say little mean things to me while she's behind her little phone tweeting, Paul Slater, you're a moron, whatever. I don't pay no mind to her. I hope Mizu teaches her a lesson today, to be honest with you.
Well, I think this one is 50-50. I think it could go either way. Both challenges in this match very evenly matched. Let's see how this one goes. And the action is underway. The bell has rung. Here we go. This has all the hallmarks to be a true classic, Paul.
Yeah, very similar styles of both of them.
Indeed. Lots of speed. Lots of agility. And lots of creativity in the maneuvers. Both locking up.
But I tell you what, you gotta wonder, if Volcano's around, because Volcano still has a settled, little beef going on with Emma Gray I've been paying attention to.
That's absolutely right. Of course, Volcano attacked Emma Gray backstage at the Great Aussie Bash, the BCW event. Oh, a dropkick from Emma Gray to Mizu. Of course, you'll recall Volcano showed up at the BCW arena. A DX Monday Night Raw war style, I should say. Trying to intimidate the BCW roster. Of course, now, as we know, BCW and OEW are both working together in close affiliation these days. Oh, what an arm drag takedown by Emma Gray. Emma Gray taking the early offensive in this match, Paul.
Yep.
Displaying her dominance.
Emma Gray is to her credit, she's a ring veteran. She's been doing this a long time. She's been all over the grid. And she's, like you said, she's been on somewhat of a roll since she's got here in OEW. And there's a pin. One, two.
Yes, right after the DDT, Paul. Yes, kicked to midsection followed by DDT. Of course, one count there. And you're absolutely right. She's also a former BCW Women's Champion. So she also knows how it is to be a champion. And of course, we saw her in the triple threat match for the OEW Women's Championship against Green Winter and Volcano at Mind Games.
I don't know how much a low blow affects a woman. I don't know, but hey, but it looks like it worked.
I think it'll still hurt, Paul. And a jawbreaker. As we know, we've come to see that Mizu likes to use a jawbreaker on her opponents routinely.
Yeah, she does.
I think she sometimes tests Bill Lawrence's patience with her style. Quite vicious in the ring when she wants to be. Now turning the tables on Emma Gray. Locking up again, these two. Again, really difficult to see who has the superior strength, which is why they're in a lockup for so long. Oh! I think Mizu just showed us there. Showing that she's got all the power and glory right now. Bringing her unique Japanese style to the ring. Oh, what a furious punch. A second one. Oh, going in for the punches. Again, testing the patience of Bill Lawrence. At tonight's official. Now, Mizu using the ropes. Gearing up for Emma Gray. What does she have in store?
Oh!
You want to say that one, Paul?
Shikaku-kuku, whatever you want to call it.
Well, nice attempt. Nice attempt. Doing more arigato, Paul. And now...
I did my best.
You did very well, Paul. And Mizu might want to think about going for the cover right now, right after that finisher. It's time to capitalize. Finish off your opponent. Don't give Emma Gray a chance to recuperate. And go for the cover.
Pin.
I think she heard me.
One, two. Ooh.
All right, kick out. Possibly a 2.999 there, Paul. Very close indeed. Emma Gray in serious trouble. Quite surprising to see the Kizakuku so early in this match. And yes, I did just say it again. With success.
You like saying that word, Danza?
The Kizakuku. And an Enziguri! Emma Gray making a comeback with that cool Enziguri. Again, both these opponents are very evenly matched. I said this had all the hallmarks of potentially being the classic, and I think we're on route to seeing that. Now Emma Gray sending Mizu into the corner. Oh, splashes her in the corner, what an impact! And now using her knee to her advantage, right into the midsection of Mizu. Emma Gray showing how ruthless that she can be. Front face lock. Taking Mizu into the center of the ring. Oh, lining up for a neckbreaker. A quick one going for the cover. This could be over, Paul.
One.
Referee taking his time. A two count. Perhaps if he was a bit faster there, it could have been a three. Emma Gray climbing to the top. He's about to take flight. And a flying splash executed with perfection. And going for the cover immediately. One, two, and a kick out. How did Mizu kick out of that, Paul?
Mizu's tough. Let me know. I know from experience how tough Mizu is. She's very tough, and it's going to take a lot more to take Mizu down than what Emma Gray just did.
No doubt about that, Paul. Of course, you were previously her manager some time ago, so you know all about Mizu Sayuri.
Oh, yeah, I was her manager for a short period of time.
But wait, look into this. Oh, it's this sharpshooter. Sharpshooter applied in the center of the ring by Emma Gray. On Mizu. And Mizu in a whole world of trouble right now. She needs to desperately find a rope or she'll be forced to tap out here. Crawling for her dear life.
Crawling over. Oh, it looks like she got the rope.
Oh, just in time. Now Emma being forced to break the sharpshooter. That was really applied superbly by Emma Gray. She really is a master of that maneuver, Paul.
Yeah, she is.
I don't think we see a match where she does not apply the sharpshooter to her opponent.
She may have got Mizu right where she wants her.
Yes, and Mizu struggling to stand. Being taken into front face lock by Emma Gray. Emma Gray trying to break out. Being sent into the ropes in an Irish whip. And now... Oh, what a dominating spear by Mizu, making a comeback in this match. Taking down the Belfast bruiser that is Emma Gray.
What a match, going both ways.
I told you this would be a classic, Paul. And it certainly is transpiring to be very that. And now Emma Gray sent into the corner with high impact. Now Emma Gray is in trouble. Oh, what a corner hip attack. Did you see that? Sending Emma Gray down to the mat.
Looks like Emma Gray felt that too.
I think so. I think we heard the yelp all the way across the ringside to the commentary position here, Paul. Well, you know what's coming now? Oh, bonsai drop. Shades of Yes Yokozuna. Of course, that is a master.
Minus 500 master. Pounds.
Yes, exactly. Of course, we see that move often from Mizu. She is the master of the bonsai drop for sure. What a match between these two combatants here on Ascension.
Uh-oh. Well, I see. I mean, she's waiting too long.
Yes, she is. Picking up by her hair again. Something else we also see routinely from Mizu, the pull of the hair. And Bill Owens not happy about that. Emma Gray.
Oh, what a drop kick.
What a drop kick into the face of Emma Gray, Paul. Now, Emma Gray in a world of trouble. We're getting the close bumps of that. Oh, did somebody say San Diego 619? Yes. I think Rey Mysterio will be very proud of that. Again, another maneuver that we see from Mizu, very excellently executed as always. Now she's working on the ribs of Emma Gray. Emma Gray writhing in pain, taking quite the punishment from Mizu, Paul. And look at that, dragging her hair again in this match.
Uh-oh.
Proving how vicious she can be too if she wants to be. Wow, Mizu is cutthroat in this match, Paul.
Mizu's bringing it all out. Look at this pin.
Slide pin. Turning into a bridge.
Two. And ooh.
Almost a three there, Paul. That was very, very close. What a great
match. I don't even think Bill knew what that pin was about. He just stood there like an idiot.
Yeah, Bill, a little bit slow tonight. He needs to get a bit more with it. What do you say, Paul? Emma Gray shoving. Oh, and delivering a super kick.
Super kick.
Beautifully done. Sending Mizu to the mat. And this match, again, one of those matches that goes back and forth. Very contentious. And also, again, this one could go right down to the wire. Front face lock now by Emma Gray. Working and grinding down Mizu. Sensible strategy to do. And now. Oh, Emma Gray using the ropes and DDTing Mizu.
Wow, what a match. You were right, Danza.
I knew this had classic rot all over it. A sensational match by two women who you know do want to rise to the ranks and eventually get a title shot. And now Emma Gray taking a chance to get her breath, regain her breath and composure in this match. But she doesn't want to take too much time. Mizu knows how to lethally turn things around when she needs to. But look, Emma calling for Mizu to get up. Is that wise, Paul?
I don't know.
Emma Gray now going to the top. I think we know what's coming now.
Whoa!
Island's fall. The finisher of Emma Gray. This could be over, Paul. Going for the pin.
That's it. One, two, and three. What a move.
It's over! Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner by pinfall! Emma Gray! What a stunning victory for Emma Gray over Mizu! And that was a classic encounter! I say classic with a capital C! That was brutal and bruising, Paul! And I'm sure Emma is very proud of that victory. That is a stunning victory. Two women who have been on a rampage on Ascension. But Emma Gray comes out on top in this match. I love to see a classic rematch of this, Paul.
Mizu was almost there. I mean, she was almost there, had her down where she wanted to. But Emma Gray, the experience of Emma Gray got her through that match and hit Mizu with that. Well, so is next week.
So very true. Again, that match really could have gone either way. Very well fought by both contenders. And a standing applause as Mizu also leaves. What a match. What a match on Ascension. Great women's match. That was a classic. Wow. It just keeps getting bigger, better here on Ascension. The thrills. Plenty more of them still to come. As guess what, Paul? We will continue the OEW Invitational Tournament next. And here we go. Okay, yes, this next match is another quarterfinal in the OEW Invitational Tournament. For the OEW Medallion, a chance to face the OEW World Heavyweight Champion, and this match is scheduled for one fall. We are the making his way down to the ring, standing at 6'5", 255 pounds, from Hollywood, California, here is the Heat Seeker, Lucadi Balak. course, guess who else will be in this tournament? Paul, the nemesis of LBA, Broly. Of course, us two who were brawling in your sesh pool last week. Be very interesting to see if their paths will cross in this tournament.
I was told by LBA prior to coming out here, the Heat Seeker title is up for grabs in this match right now.
The Heat Seeker title? Wow! Wow! An impromptu title match! Wow! Two things at stake here, an advancement to the tournament, and a chance to win the Heat Seeker title. Very interesting indeed. And his opponent, about to make his way to the ring, at 5'11". At 215 pounds from Hayabusa Joint in Yokohama, Japan. Here is the 45 caliber.
And you're outside here, let me make
Magnum.
Who the hell is this guy?
Some loser.
Well, he's a newcomer. Oh, that's awesome. I think he has a mic.
Dude's name is literally Shit Condom. Deuce Magnum. Think about it.
Well, that's LBA we can hear. Kissing his opponent. Yes, of course, Deuce Magnum, a newcomer here in OEW. Going 1-1 against LBA. And yes, not only is the Heat Seeker title up for grabs, but also an opportunity to advance to the semi-finals of the OEW Invitational Tournament. Clearly another Japanese wrestler to the added to the roster here in OEW. This is going to be very interesting to see the 45 caliber superstar.
Deuce Magnum. What do we know about Deuce Magnum, Danza?
Well, very little, to be quite honest, and I'm looking forward to finding out.
I mean, what a debut here. I mean, you're debuting in the tournament.
Yes, yes. Oh, oh, what a clothesline from LBA.
Seriously now? Serious?
Taking early control in this match, stomping on his opponent. Deuce Magnum being welcomed ungracefully to an OEW ring. Oh, serious, a stomp there, Paul. LBA is relentless.
Must be pretty confident putting this out on, putting this Heat Seeker title up. That's, you know, the Heat Seeker title is not, you know, and it's not affiliated with the OEW. OEW does not recognize the Heat Seeker title.
Well, unsanctioned as it may be, the Heat Seeker, is he being a little bit overconfident?
Thank you.
Oh, and come back by Deuce. Deuce Magnum punching LBA. Oh, what a chop. A kick to the midsection. Taking control of the match now. The newcomer, the 45 caliber superstar, Deuce Magnum. Now lining up. Lining up LBA. What's he got in store? Gonna be very interesting to see the sense of his wrestling technique and style in this match. As we broadcast across the globe on YouTube for OEW Ascension. And the fans liking what they're seeing, being very vocal. And now.
What the hell is this?
Sent to the outside.
Check his hands, ref. Ref, I think he got knuckles. Check his hands.
Oh, he's asking to check his hands.
Look at this.
Yes, LBA.
You come into an OEW ring all stacked up like you a big man or something like that. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing. You were like Bill, watch him. Watch him, Bill. He gonna try something slick. Watch him.
Of course, LBA being very vocal about his opponent on the outside of the ring. Perhaps some mind games going on here.
That's the thing, Phil. Yeah, check it out.
Wait, did you just see that? I think LBA just exposed the turnbuckle in the corner. Bill Lawrence attending to it. And a low blow! Ah! Behind the referee's back.
Bill.
There's the pinfall.
Out of it. Going for the cover. One, two. Oh, just a two, a kick out. I thought we were going to have a three ups. I thought it was going to be an upset there, Paul.
Take the low blow, pin for a three count. Why did you get a kick out? Why? You going to get up? You going to stand up? Low. Magnum. Stand up.
Oh, Luca.
Yes, LBA.
Yeah, I mean, he's talking to Magnum. I mean, I don't know.
Clearly resorting to underhand tactics in this match, ensuring the referee didn't see any of it. Now sending Deuce into the ropes. Oh, he comes back with a drop kick. Now we're finding out what the 45 caliber superstar right, is all about. Oh, and a second drop kick. And now Deuce back in the attack. But LBA performs a KO. And now a series of punches by LBA to Deuce Magnum. Oh, and a leg sweep taking down his opponent.
Big set of moves there for LBA. Taking down Deuce Magnum.
Yes, Deuce Magnum. Perhaps taking a more than he can handle in this match of the quarterfinals of the OEW Invitational Tournament. Oh, and a snap powerbomb with authority by LBA. And a hammerlock DDT going for the cover quickly, Paul.
We got one. Two.
Three.
Oh, it was a three count.
Yes, taking care of Deuce Magnum early in this match. And here is your winner, the Heat Seeker, Lucardi Black. And the Heat Seeker will...
Two to go.
Heat Seeker signaling that he wants to go all the way to the final of the tournament. He, of course, does advance to the semi-finals, getting one step closer to that medallion prize, Paul.
Absolutely, and I tell you what, LBA, with the streak he's been on, he's probably an odds on favorite to win this tournament, but from what I'm being told, his nemesis, Bray Blackheart, is also in this tournament.
That's very true, very true. Interesting to see if their paths will cross, Paul.
It will be very interesting.
That will be another brawl for sure. No doubt about that. So, we have two semi-finalists in the OEW Invitational Tournament. Of course, Parker advanced in our opening match. About to make his way to the ring. Accompanied by his manager, Lex Umaga. Standing at 6'11", at 325 pounds, from Cleveland, Ohio, here is the Renegade, Bannock Ogg. Of course, where the Renegade goes, Lexi Maga goes, Paul.
Yeah, well, when Bannock's around, you know Lex is not far behind, and there's Lex right there.
Of course, Bannock Ogg, the Renegade, seeking a rematch for the Diamond Sands Championship. Last week, Gideon Ozil said that he'll have to go through a series of hoops to get there. I believe we're going to hear from Lex Umaga.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is great to be out here representing my client, Bannock Ogg. It is so wonderful to see each and every single one of you out here today. But you know what? As much as we try to stay positive, the negativity always finds its way to creep in. And you know what? Mr. Gideon Olzu, what you did was absolutely ridiculous. Putting us through these traps and all that. That's not how you do a fair fight. My client, Mr. Ogg, is entitled to a rematch for the Diamond Sands Championship community. And you want to put us through all this? That's fine. You can do your smoking videos video. You can say what you want to say. I have enough confidence in Mr. Bannock's performance in this ring. So today, you want to put him through a tables match? Then we're going to have a tables match. And I guarantee to all of you out here, sitting out here right now, that Mr. Bannock is going to overcome these odds.
Well, I mean,
and his opponent, about to make his way to the ring, standing at 6'3", 260 pounds, from Atlanta, Georgia, here is the Mad Titan, Duke Atkins.
Well, it's been a while since we've seen Duke Atkins in action.
Indeed it has. And it'll be a tough test for him against the Renegade. Did I understand that right, Paul? This will now be a tables match?
That's what I'm hearing.
Okay, tables match, one of the hoops that the Renegade has to get through to get his Diamond Sands championship match, rematch. So someone needs to shout, Devon, get the tables!
Of course, this should indeed be interesting. This should be an interesting match, tables match.
Of course, the objective of the tables match is to put your opponent, send your opponent crashing through the table to obtain the victory. Here we go, the bells are in action underway. Renegade going straight for Duke Atkins, the Mad Titan. Taking him down.
You gotta wonder how, I mean, what Lex Dumaga's gonna do on the outside to help Bannock through this table match. I mean, what kind of advice, what kind of positive reinforcements is he giving Bannock for such a violent match?
Well, yes, there's one thing for certain, that since the alliance between Lexi Maga, oh, over the top! The Renegade sending Duke Atkins over the top to the outside. Oh, wow, crashing thunderously outside. And the brawl continues outside at ringside. Yes, you're right. I think that since the alliance between Lexi Maga and the Renegade has taken place, the Bannock Ogg, the Renegade, has become more formidable as an opponent for sure. And it, of course he also...
Yeah, absolutely.
And now it seems that the Renegade is searching for a table early in this match. I don't think he wants to waste any time, Paul. Remember, you have to send your opponent crashing through that table.
And there's... looks like...
So what is the strategy, excuse me, of the Diamond Sands champion, Gideon Olzu? Why is he thinking that this is a hoop that the Renegade needs to go through? What is the plan?
I mean, he's making... I guess he wants to make Bannock pay for all his sins.
Yes, that's right. He did say he wants to cleanse the soul of the Renegade. And now, the Mad Titan, taking his breath, regaining his composure. Perhaps the Renegade needs to focus I'm not allowing that to happen. I look at the Renegade. Guarding that table.
I mean, it must be. I don't know. Oh, look at this!
Oh my god, and that table is broken into two! Which means I do believe we have a winner!
Wow, he threw him right over the top rope onto the table!
Yes, and here is your winner! Via the crashing through a table! The Renegade! Bannock! Arg! Okay, the Renegade. Bannock Arg. Successful. That was short, sharp, and decisive. Wasting no time, sending the Mad Titan through the table, claiming victory and a step closer to the Diamond Sands Championship. Do you think that will send a message to Gideon Ozu, Paul?
I mean, Gideon's got to be watching somewhere.
Yes, you know, these two are going to square up again eventually. Perhaps there'll be some more hoops. We will find out. But Gideon Ozil seems to be enjoying playing with the Renegade. But the Renegade, thus far, taking it in his stride. I was surprised at how short that match was. But right now, Paul, leaving the table, going someplace, huh?
I am. Let's go, Bree.
Of course, heading to the ring. The Scumbag Superstar with Black Ops 3 in tow. And you will recall, it happened to this week, an open challenge was set by the Scumbag Superstar on Twitter, aka X, wrestling handle, Wrestling OEW.
If you people are paying attention to X or Twitter, whatever the hell you want to call it, you will notice a video I put up this week issuing an open challenge to any woman who has the woman balls to come out and face my girl Bree here so I can show the world how destructive she is. So, having said all that, whoever feels they have enough courage, please make your way out now. And we can get this over with.
Oh, wait! Wait! That's the music of BK!
What is he doing here?
Look,
Bree, come back. Come back, Bree. Come back over here, Bree. Bree, back over here. Come back over here, Bree.
BK Tigerfish!
What are you doing here? You're not allowed to be here. You're not allowed. You're done. You're done. Bree, come on back. Bree, back up. Back up. It's an order, Bree. Let's go. Back up. Don't go near her. Back up.
Paul. Pauline. Pickle Paul. You Philadelphia piece of shit. You were in such a hurry, and you were so believable in yourself that you had all your problems solved trying to get rid of me. You didn't actually read the contract. Because, yes, you're right. I did agree not to wrestle. Never said anything about I couldn't manage.
Oh, my God.
So now, you get to go tell that lovely real-life wife of yours that even in SL, you can't get the job done because you are just so self-centered. You are so convinced that you are completely right that you miss all the little details to be able to make anyone happy.
BK. You know what? BK? Me and you will handle this. business later. We have a job right now, and it's an open challenge. So unless you have somebody you're going to bring out here, get the hell out of the ring. All right? I'll deal with this with the people in the back, with the people in charge later with you. All right?
Hey, Paul, sit down and shut the fuck up and listen. Yes, I heard about your little open challenge. And, Paul, it has already, it's already been one of these things where it seems to be that your past always comes back to bite you in the ass. So, yes, I am now managing. And you know what? I have somebody. Blast from your past, Paul, that is ready to accept your challenge. Brittany, hit it, please.
A blast from my past. Take it easy, Brie.
Can you see me?
I'm fine.
Oh no. Oh no, you gotta be kidding me. Brie, back up! Brie, back up! No! Brie, back up! Brie,
I'm afraid of her.
Brie, back up. You know what? You know what? We're not doing this now. Come on, Brie. Back up. We're not doing this now, BK. No, back. That's an order, Brie. That's an order. Back up. We're out of here. We're not playing this stupid games, you BK. This shit ain't over with. Come on, B. Come on, Brie. No, we're not doing this today. We're not doing this. Come on, Brie. No, you listen to me. That's an order. That's an order, Brie. We're not playing this game today. You know, this isn't over, BK. This isn't over. This isn't over. Let's go, Brie. Calm down, Brie. Listen, trust me. We don't want to mess with this today. Come on, let's go. You shouldn't even be here.
I sacrilege. Let's go.
Come on, Brie. Let's go.
Whatever.
Son of a bitch. Tiesa!
A blast from the past to return to haunt Paul and Paul, the scumbag superstar Slater, and Black Ops Brie are all here, scared, terrified, petrified. I think it's safe to say that the return of Sacrilege, BK has brought Sacrilege back. Where is this going to go? Paul is not happy. I think I'm out here without a color commentator right now. Wow. I think it's safe to say that Paul and Brie have hightailed it for the evening here on Ascension. Wow, stunning stuff. And what a surprise to see BK back, whose career was ended by the Scumbag Superstar at 9 games. Oh, he's not going away. We can see that. He might not be able to wrestle, but I think Sacrilege can. And maybe doing it on his behalf. We will see. A Volcano making her way to the ring. And she's looking for a microphone. I think she has something to say.
Seriously, I missed it. I wanted to accept this challenge. I wanted to face Brie and everything. But seems like they are just tiny little cowards that can't face their own past. Guess it's just up to me to do this. The audience was promised an open challenge, so I will bring them an open challenge. I will challenge anyone in the back to match right here, so that the audience can get what they were promised right now, right here.
Well, there you have it, an open challenge issued by Volcano, and oh, that's the music of Jenny Mulkey. Wow, another surprise here on Ascension. Of course, Jenny Mulkey regained the right to replay her music, which we're hearing right now. She must be elated. It seems that Jenny Mulkey is answering the challenge, the open challenge of the Alpha Predator Volcano. Clearly, Jenny, very happy to be here on Ascension. But is it so wise answering the open challenge of Volcano? We're going to find out in this impromptu match. Yes, as you can see, Volcano already in the ring from Fort Worth, Texas. She's 5'9" at 212 pounds. And her opponent, Jenny Mulkey, from Morristown, Tennessee, at 5'3". She's 150 pounds. A big size difference between these two in this impromptu match. And Bill Lawrence is about to call for the bell. Here we go. It's now time for this action to get underway. An impromptu match between Jenny Mulkey and Volcano. Let's do this. Yes, the bell has rang. Here we go. And you can hear Jenny complaining that this is a bit of a mismatch. Well, you did answer the open challenge, Jenny. Be careful what you wish for. No, I don't think you're going to be allowed to pause. Volcano's not allowed that because she's going in for a series of Fury punches and a headbutt. Oh! Oh, you can feel a headbutt reverberate around the arena. Volcano wasting no time. Oh, what a kick. Delivered with brutality. Volcano taking charge in this match. Oh, what a knife-edge chop. And perhaps RIP here, rest in peace with Jenny Mulkey, we'll find out. Volcano is vicious. Reading the last rites to Jenny Mulkey. And this match may be over before it's even got started. And as Paul mentioned earlier, Volcano in a long-running dispute and feud with Emma Gray, who we saw earlier tonight. Oh, Rick to the eyes. Oh, and another punch. Seems that Bill Lawrence turning a blind eye to the Rick in the eyes. The Volcano just dominating Jenny Mulkey. Oh, what a sick kick by the Alpha Predator. Was Jenny Mulkey a bit overzealous in answering the open challenge? I think you guys can decipher the answer for that. Oh, a burning lariat! Nearly taking the head off of Jenny Mulkey, going for the cover. No! No cover just yet. I don't think Volcano has finished. What a burning lariat. I think Volcano is just getting started. Aggressively picking Jenny Mulkey, sending her into the ropes. Ha ha! Boinging back to a clunk. Jenny doing an old school punch to Volcano, trying to make her way back into this match with a series of punches. Not taking much effect on Volcano, that's for sure. And Volcano sending Jenny Mulkey into the corner. That's one place that you don't want to be. When Volcano has you cornered, it's not going to be pretty. Here we go, supercharge, but she misses. She misses. The corner splash. Wow, Jenny was very quick there to hightail it and get out of Dodgetown. Oh, what a Judas effect by Jenny Mulkey. Wow, what a comeback. What a turnaround. Don't underestimate Jenny Mulkey. Of course, Jenny thinks that she is the one. And Jenny going to the outside. Jenny appearing to conceal where she is. Question is, will Volcano need to be able to sniff her out? Unless he's got a cold. We're going to find out. Can Volcano find the hiding Jenny Mulkey? Quite frankly, I don't blame her for hiding. I would hide too if Volcano was after me also. Referee counting both competitors out and Volcano has found Jenny Mulkey. She has caught her prey. It looks like... It looks like we're descending into Animal Planet here. On Ascension. And now, Volcano, throwing Jenny Mulkey back into the center of the ring. Knowing that right now, this is her ring. And when she wants a magma to erupt, volcanic as it will be, she can do so at any given time. Now Volcano toying with Jenny Mulkey, knowing she has her in her firm grasp. What a match this is. It was an open challenge. Again, I think Jenny Mulkey seriously regrets it right now. And Volcano taking her time. She is enjoying brutalizing Jenny Mulkey. Perhaps sending her a message to her nemesis, Emma Gray, who I'm sure is watching also here on YouTube. Wait! Speak of the devil! Wait! That's the music of Emma Gray! Oh my gosh! And Volcano, clearly distracted by Emma Gray's music blasting throughout the arena. Wow! What's going on here? Is Emma Gray gonna come out? But Jenny making light of the situation. Telling Volcano she should not be distracted by the music. Of course, she knows all about that. Oh, and a bulldog by Jenny on Volcano. Are we going to have an upset? Is this going to be over? Wow! And Emma Gray is here ringside. She's come to the commentary position. Here is Emma Gray. Right beside her is at the commentary broadcast booth. Getting a closer inspection of the action. Clearly trying to put and distract Volcano, the Alpha Predator. As Jenny gives a rake to the eye, stomping and slapping Volcano. Definitely delivering the Jenny effect there for sure. But Lawrence not happy with the eye rake and going for the cover. Excuse me. Oh, going for the cover one. Oh, just a one count and a kick out. Yeah, Volcano kicking out very quickly there. Clearly distracted by Emma Gray, who appears to have joined us at the commentary position. Not sure if she's going to take her headset and join me here on the broadcast commentary. We'll find out, I guess. I just think Emma Gray is making herself comfortable and seeing, maybe hoping, that Volcano will fall to Jenny Mulkey. This will be an upset if Jenny Mulkey can take the victory over Volcano, that's for sure. And now, Jenny Mulkey going up top. This one could be over. We might have that upset. Jenny, but Volcano back to her feet. Jenny up top. Oh! Volcano caught her and turned into a Batista bomb. Oh, Dave Batista, eat your heart out. That was sensational. That was an epic comeback. Perhaps the music of Emma Gray will not cost Volcano this match, but it very nearly did. I don't know whether Jenny can recover from that Batista bomb. Now Volcano, close to success. Jenny Mulkey in serious trouble here. Oh, taking Jenny into a bear hug. Trying to squeeze the dear life out of Jenny Mulkey. Mulkey, Jenny screaming in pain. Sucking the air. She's going to pass out. Oh, Volcano throws her to the ground like a piece of meat. A carnivore, a predator in waiting. Volcano looking to finish Jenny Mulkey off. Oh, Lou Fest press mount. Saying to Steve Austin. Oh, you don't see many Lou Fest presses. I love that maneuver. One of the all-time greats. And now we're going for a sharpshooter. Oh, she's locking in Volcano with the sharpshooter on Jenny Mulkey. And this one can be all but over. The referee, Bill Lawrence, checking in on Jenny Mulkey. Oh, Jenny screaming in pain. And yes, that is the maneuver of Emma Gray that we saw her apply to Mizu earlier tonight, as she does week in, week out. And she's tapped out. It's over. It's over. Here is your winner by submission, the Alpha Predator, a Volcano. And perhaps, Emma Gray, that was a message to you, using your move, using your sharpshooter. Perhaps that was saying, you're next. And Jenny Mulkey thriving in pain. What a match. That was brutal by Alpha Predator. Chung Wai, she is one of the most dominant forces in all of the Edge wrestling. Thank you very much for joining us, Emma Gray. Good to see you and have you up here with us on OEW Ascension. Jenny Mulkey struggling. Valiant effort, Jenny. And well done for answering the open challenge. And guys, what a night! What an epic Ascension! We've had the surprises! We've had the return of the OEW Invitational Tournament. It will continue next week, but still to come is our main event of the evening. Yes, this one also has all the hallmarks of being a classic momentarily. And here we go. Yes, it's now time for the main event, and it is scheduled for one fall. About to make his way down the aisle, standing at 5'11" and 190 pounds, from Swansea, Wales, here is the insane one, Alex Carmino! Of course, Alex Carmino is now the former Hardcore Champion. He was defeated by Hiroto Katsu in last week's main event. And introducing his opponent. About to make his way down the aisle. Standing at 6'4", at 231 pounds, from San Antonio, Texas, here it is, the Culture, Skillex. And here he comes, baseball bat in hand. He's also the reigning BCW Heavyweight Champion of the World. And Skillex, hot off the heels of an awesome Man Games main event against the OEW Heavyweight Champion, Tank Ventura. He is not forgotten about Tank. Last week we saw Superstar try to impersonate the Culture with very little success, may I add. But clearly, I don't think things are over between Tank Ventura and Skillex. I think Skillex wants to show that he truly is one of the best champions of all time, and he needs the OEW Championship to prove that too. And this, again, I'm going to go out and call this another potential classic match between these two formidable opponents. The bell has rang and we are underway. Here we go. Yes, it's main event time on OEW Ascension. Alex Carmino and Skillex locking up in the center of the ring. This one is going to be very interesting indeed. Both men trying to show their superior strength, but Skillex taking a fierce side headlock, showing lots of aggression with this opening maneuver. Alex Camino, wait, quickly reversing it. Ah, turning the tables on the culture. Back and forth between both these competitors as Skillix reverses the front face headlock. Skillix takes Alex Camino down to the mat. Not letting go, applying the pressure. Stalling Alex Camino, the insane one. When he's all, oh, throwing a punch in there too. Bill Lawrence will not be happy with that. Oh, a series of punches. Whilst maintaining the headlock and grip on Alex Camino. Bill Lawrence clearly not happy with those punches. I don't think Skillix really cares right now. He is just really trying to grind down the former hardcore champion, Alex Camino. And this headlock being applied for quite some time, wearing Alex Camino down. What an arm drag takedown. A methodical and very technically gifted wrestler that is the culture, Skillix. Applying the pressure, wearing his opponent down right from the onset in this match. And I say it's a very smart strategy to do. You wear your opponent down, disorientate them, take the wind out of their sails. We all know that Alex Camino likes the insanity in the ring. But if he's worn down, he's not going to be dishing up much insanity in this match. And now a fierce side headlock again. Ruthlessly applying that headlock on Alex Camino. And Alex Camino is struggling here. Sending Alex Camino into the ring. Oh, and a comeback with a dropkick to the face of Skillix. And that won't do any favors to the kisser of Skillix. Trying to get back to his feet. Oh, and Alex Camino with another dropkick to the face. Showing why he is the insane one. Yes, a lover of the insanity in the ring. And a third dropkick. Oh, over the top. Over the top rope. Skillix to the outside. Right here near the commentary position. Now Alex Camino taking charge. And Skillix looking very wobbly and disorientated as Alex. Oh, does a suicide dive over the top rope. Onto the culture. And Skillix is in trouble now. Bill Lawrence counting both men out. They've got to the count of 10 to return to the ring. I told you, fans, this would be a potentially classic match. I think we're starting to see that right now as Alex Camino throws Skillix back into the ring. Now we're starting to see that display of insanity by Alex Camino. What a suicide dive he did over the top rope earlier in this match. Now he's seizing his opponent. Skillix struggling to get back to his feet. And Alex Camino waiting. Oh, using top rope and a missile dropkick. Sending Skillix straight to the mat. Oh, what a high impact maneuver. Going quickly, going for the kick and the pin. One, two. Just a two and a kick out. Alex Camino frustrated. Really delivering it and bringing it to the culture. No doubt about that in this match. Oh, this match. Not all. And Skillix kicks his way back into this match against Alex Camino. Back into the headlock position and a scoop slam. Now reversing the tables in this match and stomping his opponent into the mat. Oh, going with a series of barrages on top of Alex Camino. A series of punches to the head of Alex Camino. Camino clearly in trouble right now. And another stomp. Skillix showing ruthless aggression and a quick cover. One, two, and a kick out. Wow. Both these men giving everything they have in tonight's main event on OEW Ascension. So in one, we are Over the Edge Wrestling. And an old school, oh, blocks the punch. Camino blocking Skrillex's punch, but wrist lock applied to Alex Camino, the former hardcore champion. And a fierce kick to the midsection of Alex Camino, sending him down into the mat. This match is proving vicious, both. Alex Skrillex taking his breath. Going to the top. Oh, and a front elbow drop on Alex Camino. Oh, what a devastating maneuver to Camino, who is now in trouble. Going for the pin. And a one, two, and a kick out. Horse. Now Alex Camino potentially in perilous trouble in the main event on Ascension. What an epic main event, Matt. Fans liking what they are seeing. Very vocal tonight on Ascension. And Skrillex dragging Alex Camino into a back suplex. Oh, taking Alex Camino down with authority. Showing why he is the reigning BCW champion. And going for a cover. One. Two. And, oh, 2.9999 all the way for sure. That was very close indeed. Alex Camino, like I said, is in perilous trouble right now. He needs to try and make a defensive comeback here in this main event on Ascension. On a night when we have had so many twists and surprises on Ascension, we do know that anything really can happen here in Over the Edge Wrestling. Camino shoving Skrillex and returning off the ropes with a vicious spear, driving Skrillex the culture down. Going for the pin, just covering him just in so. One, two, and a kick out by Skrillex. This is not over yet. And yes, this is transpiring into a classic main event. Oh, these two exhausted, both down. The referee will be surely making the count on both these until they get back to the feet. Camino struggles to get back up. He's there. What will both men do to ensure victory in this classic main event between two of OEW's greatest superstars? Oh, what a back suplex slam by Alex Camino. I didn't know he had it in him. Looking exhausted, but trying to regain the momentum in this match. Going for a cover and out. One, two, and another kick out. Wow, resilience clearly on display by the culture Skrillex. Breathtaking main event here on Ascension, fans. What? I really don't, I won't like to be a betting man on this match. This really could go either way, but Alex Camino, meanwhile, ascends to the top, giving his projection of Ascension. And a, oh, burning star press. Oh, one of his signature maneuvers, a burning star press. And now, Skrillex is in deep water in this main event now. Camino going for the pin. One, two, and another kick out again, showing that robust resilience that Skrillex exudes. What a classic encounter. This match is off the page and unbelievable. Alex Camino slowly taking the hair of Skrillex. Going to punch, but a counter by Skrillex, taking him back into the fierce side headlock. Now, with all his aggression and so much pressure, Skrillex, oh, he throws Alex Camino across the ring, going for the cover, and a one, two, three, it's over! And here is your winner of the main event, by pinfall! The Culture! Skellex! Outstanding victory for Skellex! And yes! Yes, 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 that was a classic main event on Ascension, as we are 4 weeks away from the big one, the granddaddy of them all, Immortality. Of course, we are broadcasting on YouTube. Be sure to like us. And what an intense main event that was. A standing ovation for both these incredible superstars who give it their all. They give it everything. And the reigning BCW champion, the Culture Skellex, standing victorious on Ascension. Skellex enjoying his moment. But wait! Oh my gosh! The world champion Tank Ventura making his way into the ring and attacking Skellex, and Superstar not far behind. Tank Ventura and Skellex ascending into an all-out brawl.
I thought you wanted the smoke. Ladies and gentlemen, your world heavyweight champion Tank Ventura and I weren't here last week, but we did hear that there was some commotion. But let's be very clear. The constant disrespect from Skellex will not stand. Being mean to the multitude and multitude of fans of Tank Ventura ain't gonna get you a shot. Trying to drive a wedge between Tank and myself will not get you a title shot. And almost losing a match like you just did, Skellex, buddy, that ain't gonna get you a shot. And let me be more clear. 100% guaranteed, put it down in writing, if you put your hands on the Superstar, that ain't gonna get you a title shot. So I am gonna put you on notice, Skellex. Like En Vogue said, never gonna get it, 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 never gonna get it. Woo, 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 woo. And none of you fans should be pushing Skellex to continue this misguided quest. He ain't man enough to take down Tank Ventura. He ain't man enough to represent you as a world heavyweight champion. That honor is reserved by the one and only Tank Ventura, and yes, you can quote me.
Well, there you have it. There you have it. Superstar and Tank Ventura putting Skellex on notice. And the mind game's been turned around. And that brawl has just descended into the backstage locker area. I'm sure security is trying to separate those two right now. Whoa, chaotic conclusion to an epic classic main event here on Ascension. All kinds of chaos tonight as we are 4 weeks away from Immortality. We will see you next week on OEW Ascension.
Let's go.